Welcome back to English class. Advanced English. First chapter, Expressing Obligations. Pre-reading activity. Read the following sentences and identify the difference in meaning. He must take care of his health. He should take care of his health. He has to take care of his health. Have you identified any difference? Maybe you do not identify. So you will identify after 5 minutes, after completion of this lesson. See activity 1. Look at the following dialogue and identify which words are used to express our suggestion, and in which words express an order, the expressions containing must, should, and have to. Patient. Is there anything serious, doctor? Doctor. Nothing serious, but you must reduce your weight. Patient. Am I obese? Doctor. Yes, you are slightly obese. So, you should avoid oily foods. Patient. Is there anything else I need to be careful about? Doctor. Yes, you have to walk 5 kilometers daily and you must not eat sweet fruits. Okay. Here, the main target of this activity is we have to identify suggestions. Okay. Those suggestions containing must, should, and have to. So here, doctor said in the second sentence, you must reduce your weight. And next, doctor also said, you should avoid oily foods. And last one is, you have to walk 5 kilometers daily. You must not eat sweet fruits. So, here the explanation. Words must and have to are used to speak about obligations and compulsions. Let us observe the pictures and read the matter that follows. It will help to learn the difference in meaning. In the first picture, a police and a biker there. In the second picture, only biker is there. So, the similarity or the difference between the two pictures is, in the first picture, the person has no helmet. In the second picture, the biker has helmet. So, see, policeman. You must wear a helmet. You must not drive without helmet. Police is imposing, ordering. Here, in the second picture, I have to wear a helmet. The person realizes that the law demands. Because of the pressure, because of the order of the police or the government, he decided to wear the helmet. That is, intentionally, because of the rules. In the first picture, the policeman uses the word must and must not to mean It is the law. The word must and must not are used where you have no choice. Use must and must not to give orders where speaker has no choice but to accept the orders or the law. In the second picture, the speaker thinks that the law demands one to wear a helmet. He uses have to express external obligation or pressure from an external source. He may not like it, but someone or something forces him to do it. In such situations, have to is used. Okay, I hope you understood the difference. If somebody imposes pressures something and there is no alternative, there is no choice, then must and must not should be used. And have to is when somebody, someone or something forces you, there is no intention in you, but external force is pressuring you. That's why you have to do that. Then have to is used. Okay. Activity 2. Give information to a young student on how to join polytechnic starting from the moment of applying for CEEP, that means Common Entrance Examination for Polytechnic. Now it is called PolySET, to the first day at college. So from the beginning of applying for the PolySET to joining and first day at college. Discuss and advise each other. Use how to, must and must not. Jot down the points in the blank space. Jot down means write down. So here. So the model answer to this is SBTET Telangana issues PolySET notification for candidates aspiring to study polytechnic. So you have to keep looking for this information in newspapers and internet. You must appear in the examination to get a seat into a polytechnic college. You have to apply for exam by filling an online application. On the day of the exam, you must reach the exam center 30 minutes before the exam commences. Once the exam results are declared and the ranks are allotted, there will be a notification for certificate verification. Then paying the fee, you have to attend for certificate verification. Then you have to put options for the college. Then seat allotment message will be received by you. Then you have to pay the prescribed fees and get the allotment order. After that, you have to submit joining order along with your certificates Xerox at the college. And after that, you have to attend the college regularly. So this is the process, model process. You can write in different ways also. Okay, right. Here, before we learned how to use must not, have to. Here, the word should is used to convey an obligation, but you have a choice to follow or not. Observe the pictures and read the sentences below. Learn the difference in meaning. See here. Keep our city clean and green. Second, help old people. Third one, fast driving is dangerous. In the above advertisements, there are some suggestions. We are free to follow or ignore the suggestions, but the messages give us good advice. In everyday language, we say the same things in the following way. See, we should help old people. We should not drive fast. We should keep our city clean and green. So, should means it is better to do. Always give suggestions using should. In other words, when should is used, it is an obligation, but you have a choice to do something as suggested. See activity 2. Speak on healthy living. Discuss and give each other proper advice. Use should in your advice or suggestion. Example, you should cut out sugar and salt from your diet. So here we have to give suggestions, health related to health, healthy living. So we can say, you should exercise daily. You should not spend much time watching TV. You must not eat fast food very often. You should eat at least 2 fruits and vegetables every day. You should not work on computer for long hours. In that way, these are modal answers. You can write anything. You can suggest. Okay, consolidated. From the beginning, we learned have to, must not. Have to is for other than third person singular. That means first person singular, plural, second person and third person plural. And the third person singular, we use has to. So, have to or has to expresses external pressure. You are doing something because of the pressure, because of the compulsory imposed by somebody something. Maybe the law, maybe the government, maybe the college, maybe the lecturer, principal, whoever it may be. So, because of the external pressure you are doing, then you have to use have to or has to. Example, he has to work in the night shift. So, the company demands. The company asked him to work in the night shift. So there is no choice. There is no alternative. You have to resign the job or you have to do that job. So you do not resign because of this reason. Resigning is not the solution. Okay. Next, had to. So, in the present form we use have to or has to, but in the past form we use had to. So this had to expresses past obligations. That means in those days, when you are in fifth class, when you are in the first class, or when you are in first semester, or when you are in the SSE, that means 10th class, that means these actions completed in the past. In that past, you are forced to do something, but not you are not doing that now, but you did it in the past because of the pressure, force, but you are not doing it now. So had to expresses past obligation. Obligation means compulsory, pressure. So, example, I had to work very hard to earn money. So that means you are getting money easily now. You are not doing hard. But in those days, in the past, you worked very hard for the money. Next, should not. Should not is negative word, should is positive word. So, should not expresses obligation. But this obligation, you have a choice. Whether you do it or not, whether you follow it or not. But it is better. Okay. Example. You should not drink while driving. That means government already imposed ban on drunk and drive. Okay. But still you are doing. Not that means you, people are doing. Okay. And the municipality says keep the city clean and green. But how many of you are keeping the city clean and green? In that way. Next, need not. Need means necessity, requirement. So need not means it expresses lack of compulsion or necessity, not required. No need. Example, I need not to go to the office today. Today I need not to go to office because it is a Sunday. Or something, some other reason is there. Next, must. Must expresses compulsion. There is no choice. You have to do it. Example, you must be health conscious. Otherwise, you will face medical problems. Okay, here, general mistakes. I must and should do it. Generally, people say, I must and should do it to express the intensity or pressure. They use both words, must and should, but it is wrong. Use must or should. Don't use both. So, the right answer is, I should do it or I must do it, but not I must and should do it. Next, students should be careful. Here, helping verb not necessary because with modal helping verbs, be forms we generally do not use. So, students should be careful. Next, tips. Use must to express suggestion. Use have to express external pressure. Should express obligation. So generally, must no choice for clarity. Should you have a choice? Have to is external pressure. Okay, clear. Here, assignment. Read the passage about the first aid for burns. Express the ideas in your own sentences using should, should not. See here. First aid for burns. Put the burnt part under cold water and run plenty of cold water over it. This reduces the heat in the skin. It is important to do this for at least 10 minutes. Remove anything tight like a belt. Take off all jewelry. Then cover the burnt part with a clean non-fluffy cloth like a clean cotton pillowcase or a towel. Don't put butter, oil or ointment on the burnt part. It only has to be cleaned again before treatment can be given. Then call a doctor or an ambulance. So you have to rewrite it using obligation words. What are the obligation words here? Should not. First, you should put the burnt part under cold water and run plenty of cold water over it. This reduces the heat in the skin. It is important and should be done for at least 10 minutes. Okay. Then you should remove anything tight like a belt. You should also take off all jewelry. Then you should cover the burnt part with a clean and non-fluffy cloth like a clean cotton pillowcase or a towel. You should not put butter, okay, oil or ointment on the burnt part. It should be cleaned again before treatment can be given. Then you should call a doctor or an ambulance. So this is a model answer. You can write in different way also. Next. Assignment 2. Rewrite these sentences using must or should or wherever applicable. A. I really need to get a haircut. I strongly recommend you watch this movie. Don't work too hard. It is important to wear a helmet when you are riding a bike. Speak only in English every day. Finish your work in time. Enjoy your work. So the answer to first one is, I really need to get a haircut. Answer is, I must get a haircut. Next, I strongly recommend you watch this movie. So recommendation, suggestion, strong suggestion. So we use should. Okay. Then you should watch this movie. Next, don't work too hard. This is also a suggestion. So you should not work too hard. Next, it is important to wear a helmet when you are riding a bike. So this is there is no choice. So you should wear a helmet when you are riding a bike. But here, yes, we can use must, should. But must is better. Next, speak only in English every day. If it is a suggestion, you can say you should speak only in English every day. If it is compulsory, in the classroom or in the premise of college or school, use must. You must speak only in English every day in college premises or in the classroom. Next, finish your work in time. So this is an order, I think. I hope if it is an order, you have to use must. You must finish your work in time. Next, enjoy your work. So if it is a suggestion, you can say you should enjoy your work. So these are the modal answers. Okay. I hope you understood well this chapter. So in this chapter, you have only obligations are there. Obligation means compulsory. Tappanisariga cheyalasinavi. ఈ తప్పనిసరిగా చేయాల్సినవి ఇదో కూడా మస్ట్ మస్ట్ నాట్ మస్ట్ అనేది తప్పనిసరిగా ఎవరైనా గవర్నమెంట్ కావచ్చు లా కావచ్చు కంపల్సరీ చేయాలి దర్ ఇస్ నో చాయిస్ అన్నట్లుగా కాలేజీలో మీరు కంపల్సరీగా మొబైల్స్ స్విచ్ ఆఫ్లో ఉంచాలి క్లాస్లో మాట్లాడకూడదు ఇలాంటి స్ట్రిక్ట్ ఆర్డర్స్ ఇంపోజ్ చేసినప్పుడు మనము మస్ట్ యూజ్ చేయాలి మస్ట్ మస్ట్ నాట్ చెయ్యాలి చెయ్యకూడదు ఇలా మస్ట్ అండ్ మస్ట్ నాట్ అలా కాకుండా సలహా సజెషన్ అనుకోండి ఏంటి పెద్దవాళ్ళకు ఎల్డర్స్కి హెల్ప్ చేయాలి నీట్గా ఉంచాలి కాలేజీ ప్రమైసెస్ నీట్గా ఉంచాలి పరిసరాలు శుభ్రంగా ఉంచాలి హెల్త్ని జాగ్రత్తగా కాపాడుకోవాలి ఇట్లాంటి సలహాలు ఇట్లాంటివి ఉన్నాయనుకోండి అలాంటప్పుడు వీ కెన్ యూజ్ ద షుడ్ షుడ్ నాట్ ఇంకా ఎక్స్టర్నల్ ప్రెజర్ నీకు ఇంట్రెస్ట్ లేదు నీకు ఇష్టం లేదు కానీ ప్రెజర్ వల్ల ఎక్స్టర్నల్ ప్రెజర్ వల్ల నువ్వు ఏదైనా ఒక పని చేయాల్సి వచ్చినప్పుడు హ్యావ్ టు హ్యాజ్ టు హ్యాడ్ టు ఇలాంటివి వాడాల్సి వస్తుంది డబ్బులు లేవు డబ్బులు లేకపోవడం వల్ల నువ్వు చాలా కష్టపడాల్సి వచ్చింది గతంలో అంటే హ్యాడ్ టు నైట్ షిఫ్ట్ చేపిస్తున్నారు 24 hours వర్క్ చేపిస్తున్నారు బోర్డ్ అంటే మన కంపెనీ వాళ్ళు ఇలాంటి అన్నప్పుడు హ్యావ్ టు యూజ్ చేయాలి సో ఎక్స్టర్నల్ ప్రెజర్ నెక్స్ట్ వచ్చేసి నీడ్ నీడ్ నాట్ అక్కడ నాట్ నెసెసరీ అను అక్కడ అవసరం లేదు నెసెసిటీ అనేది కనిపించట్లేదు అట్లాంటప్పుడు మనం నీడ్ నీడ్ నాట్ అనేది యూజ్ చేస్తాం దిస్ ఇస్ ద మెయిన్ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఇన్ దిస్ చాప్టర్ సో ఐ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఆల్ ద స్టూడెంట్స్ ప్లీజ్ రిపీట్ ఇట్ వన్స్ అగైన్ and understand well and get ready for the examinations so in examination point of view you get 1 mark questions and 3 marks questions they give you one sentence keep the city clean and green using the obligation suitable obligation yeah you have to say you should keep the city clean and green sometimes they give you blanks just like fill in the blanks like you dash in bracket must should have to has to again wear helmet while driving a bike so you must wear helmet in that way I dash have to must not should wear helmet while driving a bike so I am doing this because of the external pressure so I have to wear helmet in that exam in examinations you get the questions okay now the session is closed